No, when you come here, it's so quiet. Well, once my family had grew up and I was looking for things to do and I didn't know what it'd be, knitting or going to old folks clubs or that, and I used to teach wee girls tap and Highland dancing, and when I had displays I always had to look for a piper to play for the Highland dancers. Sometimes you couldn't get one, so I thought it'd be a good idea if I would learn to play the bagpipes. I was in the Braemar Ladies and we played in the Metropole and the Pavilion in Glasgow. But I had stopped it for a while, for about 20 years, and I missed it, you know. So when I seen the pipe band out here and I spoke to the pipe major and I told him I used to play the pipe, so they allowed me to play with them. You know, I'm maybe not as good as I was at one time, but I still enjoy being able to blow the pipe. I think if an old pensioner went to a pipe band in Glasgow and said, I want to join, you know, say, aye, right hen, you know. But in here, I mean, they gave me a uniform and they gave me the use of bagpipes and all that. If you're angry about something, you can blow it out of you, depends on what tune. I had a triple bypass heart operation, right? And the doctors had said to me, you've got two chances. You will either die or you'll be a vegetable. But I didn't die and I wasn't a vegetable. So when I came out of it, you know, and I thank God for letting me live, so I decided I'm going to live. So I'm cramming as much as I can into what's left. It's like I've been given another life. You hear people saying, oh, you only live once. And I say, no, you don't.